Hi everyone! Today we are making hoop gliders. Hoop gliders look like this and they fly like this. They are a form of paper airplane and they fly just as far, if not farther, than a paper airplane. They're also way easier to make. Hoop gliders use the four forces of physics involved in flying, just like a real airplane. Those forces are gravity, pulling it down, lift, lifting it up, thrust, moving it forward, and drag, pushing it backwards. Let's talk about each one. So gravity, of course, is the force that acts on all of us, bringing it down. Lift is the force that causes anything to fly at all. And so that comes, in our case, from these curved wings. So these wings are curved so that air can go over it quickly and under it slowly, causing a difference in air pressure, and that generates lift. Thrust, in my case, comes from the force my arm is putting on it to push my hoop glider forward. In a real airplane, thrust comes from the engine. And finally, you have drag. Drag is the wind resistance on our airplane. You can feel wind resistance if you're ever in a moving car and you stick your hand out the window and you can feel that air pushing against your hand. That's drag. So let's make a hoop glider. To do that, you need a 3x5 note card, a plastic straw, scissors, and tape. So we'll start with our 3x5 note card. We're gonna cut two lines into it like this, so we have three long, even strips. So we'll cut right here. And don't worry about making them perfectly even. It's pretty forgiving. Once you have your strips cut, they should look like this. So we're going to take one of them and make our first hoop, our smaller hoop. We'll do that by taking this, curving it around like that into a circle, and then we're going to put a little piece of tape on the top like that. And so I have overlapped my paper, and that's really important to make sure that you have a smooth transition. So I will take my piece of tape, lay it here. And there's my first hoop. Setting that aside, you're gonna take your second two strips and you're gonna take them together to make one long strip. So I'll do that now with my tape. Now it's one big long strip. And now I am going to do the same thing that I did with the small one. I'm going to curve it into my big hoop and lay a piece of tape over. Again, don't forget to overlap. So now you should have a big hoop and a little hoop. Now we take our straw. Now what I like to do is I like to put the tape on the straw first. And so I put it right here. And then I take my hoop and I lay my straw inside the hoop and press it down onto the bottom, like that. Then I take my smaller hoop and do the same thing. Start by putting the tape on the straw and putting the straw in the hoop. And there you go. Now you have a hoop glider. Let's test it out.
Feel free to stop the video while you reflect on the following questions. Does the placement of the hoops on the straw affect its flight distance? Is it better to fly the big hoop in the front or in the back? Why does the plane design work? How does it use the four forces of flight?